Hello, I'm Jeremy Wright, Senior Consultant at Umbrella Consulting, and in this SYSPRO Quick Tip, I'm going to show you how to import custom form data using quantum import. And yes, it is possible. So first thing I'm going to do is show you the quantum import here on the import tab. And I'm just going into the master data, and I'm going to switch to method update, because most custom forms have an entry even if it's blank. And on the list here, for the data to be imported, I'm going to scroll right down to the bottom, and I'm going to look at utilities, custom form data. And this is the information that we're going to need to import some data. So you can see there's form type, key field, field name, and then alphanumeric and date value. So let's figure out what those mean, and I will show you where to find them. Form type means the module that the custom form is in. So for example, if it's a field on customer master, the form type is going to be something like CUS, and I'll show you where to find that. So I'm going to go to administration tab, I'm going to go to custom forms, I'm going to let that load here, and what we're going to see is all the different forms that allow custom fields. And so if you've made a custom field, it will be in here somewhere. And we mentioned customer, so I'm going to go and see if there's anything under the customer here on my list. And there's customer, so you can see the code here. This is the form type, so CUS in this case. I'm just going to equip this to see what fields I have. And if you see here, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 7 fields, and these are the captions. So you can see, you know, like order acknowledgement, email 1 and 2 are custom fields on the AR customer. And in this case, the field name is what I need for the import. So OA_001. So let's run back to our quantum. Import master data, or go to the import tab here and go to quantum master data. I'm going to do an update. Scroll right down to the bottom. Custom form data. And the form type that we just looked up was CUS. The key field would be the customer number in this case. If you were doing a sales order header import, it would be, the key field would be the sales order number. If you were doing some sort of supplier update, it would be the supplier number. The key field is whatever the document is that you're importing the custom data for. So key field, let's go with customer one. Field name with OA_001. And the values here, it's only ever going to be one. So it depends on what the custom form type is. Probably 90% of the time it's going to be either alpha or a date. In this case, it's just an OA email, so it's going to be alpha. And I'm going to go test at umbrella.com. Then I'm going to validate. Assuming everything is good, I'll get a green check mark, and that means that I've done everything right, and this alpha value is going to go into this field name, which is order acknowledgement email 1 for this customer. This is just a blank line that happens sometimes. So if I hit import, okay, to start importing, yes it is, and huzzah, that's all there is to it. So thanks for watching, and feel free to like and comment if you want to see something else. Thanks.